is Katherine, and this is going to be the best video about kidney disease you'll watch this year. I'm telling you this because there are five, yes, just five things you absolutely need to know if you want to lower your creatinine levels and reverse kidney damage. These things are the five keys to your success against kidney disease. In today's video, I'll show you what they are and how to use them to unlock your best health and wellness. And by the way, if you're new here in OO Kidney, welcome to our journey together to a better kidney health. Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell. What I'll show you in this video is that there are ways to get your kidney function back. It's not easy, I know. But I've seen people do it, and some of them have even shared their stories here on OO Kidney. Let their stories be your motivation to beat kidney disease. Now, let's start immediately with the very first key to your success against kidney disease. Key to success number one, know your enemy. Okay, this is, in my opinion, the very first thing doctors should tell their patients when they diagnose them with kidney disease. We're talking about assessing the damage here, okay? And this is very important. I know this part is scary, especially for new patients. I've even met people who would prefer not to know. But also consider this. Patients who take an active role in their healthcare and treatment decisions always have better overall outcomes. This is why you need to know very well how much your kidneys are working, and you have to take control. Here's how to do this. In this slide, we can see the stages of CKD and the symptoms each one of these stages will cause. Now, there are five stages of CKD. From stage 1, where there are basically no symptoms and no complications, to stage 5. As we can see, the severity of the symptoms increases as the functionality of the kidneys decreases, right? The stage of chronic kidney disease you're in depends on the GFR or glomerular filtration rate. Okay? That's an accurate measure of how much your kidneys are working. Don't worry if you don't know what GFR means. I'll explain that in a moment. For now, let's say that it corresponds to your kidney function. As we can see here, if your GFR is more than 90 or 90% of kidney function, you are in stage 1, okay? Between 89 and 60 is stage 2. Stage 3 is between 60 and 30, and stage 4 is below 30. In stage 5, kidney function is less than 15%. Now, there are two very important things to learn from this. First of all, don't trust the symptoms of CKD for assessing the damage. I always tell this to every single patient asking me for advice about the symptoms of kidney disease they may be having. If you have reasons to think your kidneys are not working properly, get tested as soon as you can, especially if you have one or more of the following risk factors: diabetes, high blood pressure, a family history of kidney disease, heart problems, obesity, and being over 60 years old. If you have one or more of these risk factors, especially diabetes and high blood pressure, get checked regularly. The sooner you get diagnosed, the more you know about your condition, the better the outcome. Consider that very few people get diagnosed at the first stages because, as we can see here, there are basically no symptoms. This means that people get instead diagnosed at the advanced stages when things are more difficult to manage. This situation could be totally different if more people would get tested before seeing the symptoms. A lot more people could completely stop kidney disease. Now, as you can see from my slide, I've listed foam in the urine as a symptom of stage 2, But that's actually really, really difficult to spot. Actually, when people get diagnosed this early is mainly because they were being tested due to risk factors for CKD they have. The second thing we need to learn from this slide is that someone with 50% kidney function will need a totally different diet and treatment approach from someone with, let's say, 10% kidney function. First of all, to treat the different symptoms and complications, obviously, but there is also going to be a different potassium restriction, different phosphorus restriction, and this is going to completely change the diet too. And I really feel like many patients have no idea how important this is. How to change this? With the second key to reverse kidney disease. Second key, being able to understand your lab values. Doing frequent checkups, blood draws, urine samples have become a part of the life of people suffering from kidney disease. These lab tests are very important for you, and your doctor should evaluate all the numbers, interpret them, and tell you everything you need to know. In an ideal world, unfortunately, the world in which many patients live is less than ideal. This is why I'm telling you that to beat kidney disease, you have to know it. You have to know in what stage you are and what is the cause of the kidney damage. It's not enough to get tested. You will need to know what the most important values on your lab results mean, okay? But don't worry, you don't have to be able to read all the numbers on your labs, just the most important ones, the four life-saving tests. Let's see what they are. First life-saving test, blood pressure. High blood pressure is the second leading cause of kidney failure after diabetes, but it's not just that. High blood pressure can cause kidney damage, and kidney damage can cause high blood pressure. Yes, it's a vicious circle if left untreated, so it's very important to keep blood pressure always under control. What are the good scores for this test? Below 120 over 80 is the best result possible. Below 130 over 80 means elevated blood pressure, and it's usually treatable. If your results are above 139 over 89, it means you have high blood pressure. This will require medications and lifestyle changes that your doctor will prescribe you. Now, this is a test you can even do at home with a very simple device. Doing it correctly and regularly is the key to understand if what you're doing to improve is working. Always write down what your results are so you can understand the trend. Second test is protein in the urine. Protein in the urine is the very first symptom of kidney disease for a lot of patients. Unfortunately, not everyone gets checked for this regularly, or their doctors don't pay enough attention to a test that could save so many lives. So, if you don't have kidney disease but you are at risk for it, get checked and pay close attention to albumin. What are the good scores for this test? Less than 30 milligrams of albumin per gram of urinary creatinine. If you have more than this, it's a sign of kidney damage. Third test is serum creatinine or creatinine in blood. This is one of the main indicators of kidney function. So, how to read this test? Normal levels of creatinine in the blood are approximately 0.6 to 1.2 milligrams per dl in adults. Now, when these levels rise, it means that kidney function is decreasing. If this happens, there's another value we should be looking at. The fourth and most important life-saving test is glomerular filtration rate, or GFR. GFR is the most sensitive and accurate gauge of kidney function. GFR tells you exactly what your stage of CKD is. As I was saying, this is the most important value. It tells you exactly how much your kidneys are working. So, get checked regularly, do regular checkups to monitor creatinine and GFR. And remember that everything you do must be fine-tuned according to your stage of CKD, symptoms and complications. But there are some dietary habits that work for every single kidney disease patient. Let's see what they are. Key to your success, number 3, the plant-based renal diet. The diet is very important if you want to reverse kidney disease. You should leverage your way of eating and use it to nourish your kidneys instead of burdening them. To do this, the renal diet doesn't have to be complicated. It has to be effective. This is why many patients have great results with the plant-based renal diet. The main focus should be to reduce protein intake to the minimum, especially those coming from meat and processed foods. Best way to achieve this? Take a look at this slide. These are all the processed foods you don't want in your renal diet. Start replacing processed foods, sugar or sodium-rich foods, including sweetened drinks, added sugars, fatty foods, processed meats with foods rich in all those nutrients your kidneys need. Follow a healthy diet of vegetables, fruits, whole grains, legumes, and nuts. Now, this is not a vegan diet. It's the smart way of eating to support the recovery of your kidneys. In fact, lean protein and fish are also included. But focus on grains low in phosphorus and potassium, like the foods in this slide. Yes, this is how you eat smart, and I know that finding the right foods to eat on a daily basis is hard for people suffering from kidney disease. This is why I've made a playlist just for you. Here, you'll find the best, healthiest, and tastiest superfoods to add to your renal diet. And these aren't just fruit and veggies. There are whole grains you can eat, there are snacks, and more. But don't forget the next key to your health. This alone could save your life. Key number 4, be very careful with the medications you're taking. Working with kidney disease patients, there's one thing that's clear for me. More people are killed by the wrong medication or dosage than by kidney disease itself. Now, if you want to defeat CKD, you absolutely need to double check every single medication you are prescribed. No, not all doctors will do this for you. This is why I always tell people to write down, to make a list of what they're taking, everything they take, and to bring this list to their doctors so they can double check. Also, do not take over-the-counter medications on a regular basis, especially NSAIDs. Non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs are known to cause lifelong lasting kidney damage if taken regularly. We are talking about very common drugs like ibuprofen, naproxen, even aspirin can cause damage. They are proven to cause up to 5% of chronic kidney disease new cases every year. And I know that many people will say, oh my god, I take that for my migraines, what do I do now? So listen, I used to take them too. It's not the end of the world. Today, use of NSAIDs has become more common than ever. Some people are used to take aspirin, ibuprofen or naproxen at the slightest symptoms of a headache or fever. Don't do that. They're not harmless. It's a lot better to avoid them if you can, especially if your kidneys are already damaged. NSAIDs are nephrotoxic, meaning that they can cause further damage. So, taking an ibuprofen or an aspirin regularly should be avoided by everyone, but especially by kidney patients. This is why it's always recommended to take analgesics at the lowest dose and for the shortest time possible. So, talk to your healthcare provider if you are taking them. Now, the most important key to improve your kidney health. Key number 5, keep diabetes and high blood pressure under control. Now, diabetes and high blood pressure are the most common cause of kidney disease. This is why I'm telling you this is the most important key. The kidney-friendly diet, the medications, the lifestyle changes, everything you do is basically aimed at keeping blood pressure and blood sugar levels under control. This will give your kidneys the chance to recover. Remember that a fasting blood sugar levels less than 100 mg per dl is normal. Anything between 100 to 125 mg per dl is pre-diabetes, and if it's 126 mg per dl or higher is diabetes. If this happens, don't worry, it can still be managed. The winning strategy is really simple and effective. Eat smart. Follow a healthy diet of vegetables, fruits, and absolutely avoid sweetened drinks and added sugars. The aim here is to keep a healthy weight, which is really important to manage diabetes. Other lifestyle changes like being physically active and avoid stress are important too. Yes, these recommendations with the needed adjustments are valid for every single kidney disease patient. Same for blood pressure. The best way to improve your kidney health is to improve your heart health. Take all the necessary steps to keep a healthy blood pressure. Remember that you can check your blood pressure at home easily and you should do it regularly. Most of the steps I'm describing in this video, the renal diet, the treatments, will help reaching the goal of lowering blood pressure to a healthy level. This is because if you want to reverse kidney disease, it's vital to keep your blood pressure under control. Okay, this was the last key to your kidney health. And stay tuned because this Friday, a very interesting video is coming. I'll show you everything you need to know about the renal vitamins, what vitamins you need to take, what you need to avoid. This is all for today. Thank you for watching. See you there.